In this video, I'm going to show you how to shoot action portraits with a puff of flour.
When photographing a moving subject, like a dancer, it's not always easy to convey that sense of graceful motion in a still image. But something as simple as a handful of flour can show off the action in a wonderfully atmospheric way. It creates an almighty mess, but that's a price worth paying for the extra dimension the flour can give our shoot. It really helps on a shoot like this if you can work with a subject who knows how to move their body. PJ here is a dancer, so I could trust him to get into interesting positions, which freed me to concentrate on perfecting the technical side of things. We began our shoot by setting up our lights. A sound lighting setup plays a major part in a shoot like this. There are two main aims with the lighting. We want to freeze the movement of our dancer and make sure the flower stands out. So flash is essential. We've got a three-speed light setup here, two positioned behind PJ on each side and a third in front to light his face. One flash has a radio trigger attached, and the other two are set to optical slave, which is S1 mode on some models, so that they fire upon detecting the first flash. Our frontal light is fired through a white shoot-through umbrella to diffuse it. The back left light has a silver umbrella and the back right a beauty dish, which both produce slightly harder light than the white umbrella. All the flashes are set to manual power mode, with the two behind at 1/16th power and the frontal one at 1/8th power. The camera is set to manual exposure, shutter speed at 1/200th of a second, aperture f6.3 at ISO 400. 1/200th of a second would usually be too slow to capture a person mid-jump without motion blur, but here it's not the shutter speed that freezes the motion of the subject, it's the flash duration, which is much faster. However, it's important to keep the ambient light to a minimum, otherwise it could have an adverse effect on our exposure, which is why we're shooting in a dim environment, in this case the underground car park below our office. It's also important to keep the background as dark as possible so that the flower shows up. So we've put up a dark tarp and a pop-up black reflector. We also need to minimise the amount of light spilling onto it by angling the flash away. At first we asked our dancer to hold flower in his hands and then release it as he danced and moved. We also tried sprinkling flower over the shoulders, arms and feet. This way, when he moved, the flower comes away in interesting patterns and hangs wonderfully in the air. And for an extra burst of powder, we experimented with throwing a spadeful of flower across the frame at the crucial moment. We tried a variety of action moves, from spins and twirls to flying kicks and jumps. This is one of those shoots where the real pleasure is in getting everything set up as best you can and then seeing what happens. Each time, the results were so different from the last shot that it was rather difficult to stop shooting. It's unpredictable, but that's part of the appeal.
So there we have it. That's how to shoot dancers covered in flour. And now for the cleanup.